It's Friday, it's the end of the working week and the end of the school week, but it's not the end of education. We're here to record the next episode of 852 Reboot Hong Kong, and we're with Joanna Hotung, who is the founder of KG Group. So Joanna, you're originally from Hong Kong.
Yes.
Born and bred, and you saw the opportunity, I believe, in 1996 to set up a kids gallery. Maybe tell us a little bit more about what that is.
Sure, so 24 years ago, there really was, what I believe, no creativity in education at all in Hong Kong. My children were very little, and they were at local kindergarten, and they were learning all these wonderful things about respect for elders and discipline, all these wonderful skills that kids learn in Hong Kong. But I felt that there was something really missing in terms of their creative development. And my older daughter, who was 4 at the time, actually failed art, because she insisted on painting an elephant orange, and her teacher argued with her that elephants can only be grey. And I realised that there was a lot more to education than that. And so I literally had a very unfocused focus group, asked a few mums if they agreed that we need more creativity in education, and they said yes. And I started in a small room, started Kids Gallery in a small room. It just grew from there.
And where is it now? Because obviously, you know, over the years, I mean, I've seen Hong Kong evolve, and the kind of art scene has improved. You know, traditionally, Hong Kong has seen as being a bit kind of lacking, a bit of a dearth for culture and art. And obviously you're proving that wrong, but how do you see that evolving from the kind of kids, the young generation over the years?
Right. For me, setting up Kids Gallery really wasn't or hasn't been to create artists or performers per se. What I really want to do is I want to create children and young people who can actually think for themselves and can actually think a little bit differently from other kids. Some of them have gone on to become performers and artists. We have actually got people working in New York, on Broadway, in London, West End, etc. But most of our children, young people, have actually gone on to become doctors and dentists and accountants. But what I really appreciate, and we stay in touch with so many of our former students, I really appreciate that they feel that they have actually benefited from a different way of learning. And 24 years ago, the phrase enquiry-based learning, which is more common now, was actually rare. And actually giving children the opportunity to decide things for themselves rather than just listen to the teacher and then regurgitate.
And do they do that through, I mean, what kind of arts are you practicing? Is it painting? Is it performance? Is it the whole range?
It's interesting because it's actually evolved over the years. So we started off just doing fine arts and crafts, visual arts. And then we added performing arts, so musical theatre, speech and drama to the mix. And that's been incredibly popular. And in fact, that then took over in popularity. And we noticed that parents were starting to want their children to develop in confidence and communication ability. So we added more communication arts, including public speaking, debating, again, developing confidence, getting the children to really start advocating for themselves. And now I would say our most popular courses are between performing and communication arts. Visual arts still very important, but sadly, parents are not prepared to invest as much money in that side of their children's development. They just want fast results. They want them to pass interviews, get into good schools, good universities. So performing and communication mainly.
And your schools have been very physical, obviously. You know, you have people in rooms using materials, performing. You know, we've the last 3 months here have, you know, turned the world upside down. How have you adapted your business? I mean, I know you have the kids gallery.
Yeah.
You've got Mills, right?
Yeah, we have a kindergarten, Mills International Preschool, and we have a production company, Face Productions, which is for teenagers and young adults who are always rehearsing for shows on stage. And we also have English language centres. So we have a whole range of educational venues. And we have 6 main campuses. So of course, with the COVID-19, we have had a lot of issues, and we've had to close down our campuses for obvious reasons, like other businesses in Hong Kong. Our kindergarten is registered under Education Bureau, so of course we have to follow what they say as well. It's been really tough, but it actually meant that it forced us to do things that we've been talking about for quite a long time, including online learning. So we've been talking about developing an online learning platform for a long time.
And how do you transition? I'm curious, because it's a very, you know, especially the performing side, or even the artwork, it's a very tactile thing. How do you transition that into the digital realm?
With difficulty. In the beginning, our teachers didn't think it would work. none of us really thought it could work, because we've always believed very strongly in the experience of the arts. And when you come into one of our centres, you're experiencing art in all of its forms, and it's very sensory. So taking that online, especially for some of our students who are really little, 2, 3, 4 years old, it's been difficult, but I have been incredibly impressed at how, when you put people under pressure, and this is what I mean by creativity, you put people under creative pressure and real pressure, financial pressure, actually you can think up and brainstorm some amazing ideas. And once we got the hang of green screens and special effects, we've actually had incredible fun putting videos together with lots of amazing backgrounds. We're reaching out to the kids. Of course, our student body is greatly reduced. Only a small proportion are actually going online. Although we've noticed it's picking up, now that people are getting used to being online, it's actually picked up a lot. Rehearsals for our upcoming shows have been very difficult. So we've really focused online on getting the performers to practice lines, practice individual songs. We've actually had Zoom rehearsals where every performer calls in or sings.
And is that a different level of confidence that you're creating there? Because getting in front of a camera, as you are now, I mean, it's a different type of confidence than being on stage. Or do you see a different skill set being taught there? I mean, it's quite interesting.
We do, actually. That's really interesting. Getting used to working with a camera is obviously an important skill for a performer. But what's also interesting is we used to do live auditions for shows, and they would have to come in and do their singing and dancing and acting in front of a panel. But now we're accepting video auditions. And what we've found is, I'm sure some of these kids have done many, many, many takes, but what we see are actually really accomplished pieces of, you know, small videos, short videos of them performing. And it really is them showing us what they can do. Normally in a live audition, they're under a huge amount of pressure. It's a very short time frame. They're nervous. They don't show what they can do at their best.
So you could argue it's, in a way, it's preparing them for the current, you know, status of content and entertainment.
Yeah.
I know, I'd love to continue, but let's get onto the plugs. Your first plug, let's tell me what you'd like to promote.
First plug, well, Kids Gallery, Face Productions, we're all open again. It's lovely to have all the campuses open. I'm so happy to see the kids and the parents coming back to classes. I think there is a confidence that things are sort of getting back to normal, and people have missed that human contact. I know the children have missed each other.
Yeah.
And now that they can get back together, even though they're rehearsing wearing masks, and they're singing their hearts out through their masks, is still wonderful. So the plug is for summer camps and summer performances, and all the information about that is at kidsgallery.com.
Excellent. I look forward to coming along to one of those. And the second plug?
Second plug is actually a charity that's close to my heart. I'm the founder and chairperson emeritus of Youth Diabetes Action. It's been a difficult time for children with diabetes. At the beginning of this pandemic, it was impossible to get alcohol swabs, which sounds like a small problem, but it's not for children with diabetes, because they're injecting themselves 4 to 6 times every single day. Alcohol swabs, hand sanitizers, all of these things are really critical. But we actually put out a sort of SOS to the community asking for people to help us and donate. Now, I was really overwhelmed.
So where could people go if they want to donate to that? Is there a specific website or a Facebook page?
It's yda.org.hk.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.